Alright guys, I just made another video a few minutes ago and finished with it, but it's 57 minutes long, and I will try to get it uploaded for people who are wanting to watch it. But it was talking about my personal feelings and beliefs and opinions on how we have come to the position that we are in right now, and why it is so important to become self-sufficient, to not be dependent upon a system for our basic needs and subsistence. My personal feelings is that we are looking at this system that we see of economics and political systems. Well, economics is going to crash. Political systems are going to be changing, and we're not going to like it. Even the people that think they're going to like it, once it gets going, they ain't. They're not going to like it. In fact, they're going to be the ones most likely screaming the hardest, because they're going to realize the lies that they've bought into. But I've talked to you about self-sufficiency, and that I feel it's more important than you even think. Just a brief synopsis of what this video was about is that earlier political systems existed to control areas and protect trade, and trade paid what could be called taxes. Back then it was called tribute, in order to be able to function. And then it gradually built into the governments actually investing into the corporate world. And now it is at a point where the corporate world is the government. Effectively, the corporate world is running everything. I think that is really no surprise to most of us. And to the corporate world, we are now a liability. And as their liability, it is very important that we become self-sufficient, that we reduce our dependency upon them, that we quit buying into this standard of living that they have fed to us for so many years. Because they have brought us now to a point, they have been using us to gain control over the entire world. They have used all governments and their intelligence systems in Africa and in South America to maintain division, to maintain hatreds, to maintain difficulties and wars among themselves. Primarily, in my opinion, because if they ever stabilized, you would see Africa becoming a world power. Same with South America. It is not because of the people of any country, and that is what a lot of people have got to stop doing. They got to stop talking about other countries and including the people of those countries. You know, I want to tell you this truth. I don't like communism. Don't like it at all, because I don't like what the former Soviet and the Russian governments and other, and China, Chinese governments and others, I don't like what the communist governments did to their people. I saw it firsthand. I saw one person getting shot in the back just because he wanted to leave. I don't like what I see the corporate world doing to America, to Europe, to anywhere else. The intelligence agencies of all governments have been working. Well, we've been told they were working against each other, but I do not, and I no longer believe that. I believe they were working together in order to maintain instability in all of these countries. And I am seeing that now in America. I am seeing it in Europe. I'm not seeing it in Russia and China, but some of the people I have talked to are telling me they're seeing it. And it's because people living in peace, not buying into a standard of living, have no need for the corporate world, have no need for big government. They have no need of control if they're living in peace with each other. They are maintaining instability. And they have been, especially in America, have been building all these little groups to maintain instability and to make people hate each other, mostly for imagined bullshit. But the point of self-sufficiency is that in order to get through what is, I feel, is about to happen, self-sufficiency is, first of all, our first defense and resistance. If enough people decided to become personally responsible enough to seek self-sufficiency, we could actually stop all this. Don't have much hope of that, but it could be possible, because self-sufficiency isn't just providing your own food. Self-sufficiency is having courtesy and respect for other people when they have different opinions of yours than yours. Self-sufficiency is living in peace with each other. Self-sufficiency is working together. So first of all, self-sufficiency is our only means of defense and resistance. Failing that, self-sufficiency is our only means of survival.